for disturbing my unpleasant emotions. This is the true empowerment and healing of the suffering, recognizing that happiness and suffering are left to us, based on how we choose to respond to our experiences. Inquiry is a third order tool. What makes it so hard to quit? What resources are available to help you obtain and recover? Worst reasons to believe you can recover. Faster is your doubts. What? Make the rising compassionate part of you. You bleed them off. Dash. Jittery. Say about these doubts. Practice. When you go, but something small. Notice the book craving. Doesn't last and that there's a little sense of relief when you let it pass. That's a little taste of freedom. The fourth noble cure. The past. The Buddha taught that by living every day, practicing meditation, yeah. Tune on, and developing wisdom and compassion, you can end the suffering. You create by resisting, running from, and misunderstanding reality. The fourth noble truth is the path that summarizes the rest. Yes. Send your elements to recovery, or awakening, and roots to the mingling of. Suffering. It provides an instructive practice for investigating your mission. Yes. Be aware of the conditioned responses you created. These are the eight factors of the path. 1. Rise understanding. 2. Rise intention. 3. Rise speech. 4. Rise action. 5. Rise livelihood. 6. Rise effort. 7. Rise mindfulness. 8. Rise concentration. These 8 factors can be divided into 3 groups. The wisdom group of understanding and intention. The ethics group of speech, action, and livelihood. The concentration group of effort, mindfulness, and concentration. Each of us will understand and practice each aspect of this. Take full track in our own way. We develop our wisdom, ethical practice, and concentration as far as we can in any given moment. As we come to a deeper understanding of the four noble truths, we're able to bring more effort and concentration to letting go of our greed, hatred, and conclusion. Our ethical development will cause us to reflect more deeply. Find the sources of our own wise actions. The Eightfold Path is a way of life that each of us follows in. Practices to the best of our current understanding and capacity. The path can serve as both a religious and non-religious journey. For many people, their Buddhist practice includes prayer, worship, and ceremony. It is up to you to decide whether to include these practices as part of your recovery path. Inquiry of the fourth noble truth. Understanding that recovery and removing of suffering is possible. What is your path to recovery and removing the suffering of addiction? Be honest about the challenges you might face and the tools and resources you will use to meet those challenges. What behaviors can you change to more fully support your recovery? What does it mean to you to take refuge in the Buddha, the Dharma, and the Sangha for your recovery? The Eightfold Path. We found that it's useful